Evening, folks. I posted a video earlier this week of a little spear and sword technique, which I thought was quite interesting. In our training tonight, we've been playing about with it, with the ideas, just to see how it works and how it doesn't work. We'll just put some thoughts on video, throw them out there, see what you all think. So if we go back to the video, this is how it was done in the vid. So we haven't got a spear. We tend to put that pointy bit on the end. Okay, so. Point's got on the end, thrust in, guy blocks it, okay? He's coming forward, and the sword's starting to come back up, okay? You can see that, so. As I thrust in, you can see what's happening. I thrust it over, I keep my body momentum going. Push and pull, a lot of momentum, a lot of physics, throw the guy over. That's the basic technique as it's shown in the video. Now, we started playing with it and we noticed something. The first thing we noticed is the way the swords when they standing. You Fiore people out there will recognize this, okay? If he's standing like that, and I go for the thrust and he blocks it, that's more likely to happen. Okay, because of where his hand is, his foot is. Okay, because I do the thrust in, I notice he's starting to move. So I go for this because his hand was forward and he's ready. I'm moving into his space and he's ready to grab. So, first things first, we'll bring a bit of George Silver into this now. We can attack. What we can attack. So, his hands forward, his legs forward, I've got a nice pointy stick. So I'll go for the leg, I'll go for the hand. I'll keep going for this side because it's forward. And as soon as he steps back, we go for the big one. Okay? Because he's now taken that out of my play because he keep hitting it or threatening it. As I come in, now, doesn't matter what happens, I'm doing the same move. That will happen, or if he goes for the attack in, because he's taking it back, I can move in, go back onto this again, so on. Because he's moved that hand and that foot back. If he starts in that position, we can try the technique. If he doesn't, we use the time, distance, and place. You know what's the first thing I can hit? I can hit that, I can hit there, and obviously I can go for the head. But I can keep attacking this side. I'm not moving in, I'm just attacking now. Okay, but the first thing we thought, while he's in that stance, his left hand forward, if I try and move in, it's far too easy to grab. What you'll also notice is that if that moves backwards, we'll try and grab the back. So if the left side is now backwards, if he tries to grab it, that's why that happened. He's got too far to move to grab it. That's the first part. Next in a minute. Next thought, or next thing we started playing with is when it starts to go wrong. A little bit. So, that side's forward, we'll force it back. Otherwise, you can go as far too easily. So, the point being, we now go for the technique. Okay? We noticed that if the other guy's ready for it, even as he can't grab it there, as he's coming in, I'm thinking, great, I'm going to go for this. If I'm not careful, I'm going to go straight into his hand. And once he's got that, the sword's free, it's a problem. So again, if you're going to go for the hook, you go for the hook. So as it comes in, and I come over, and make sure I come over. Anyway, it's not ideal, but I'm not this, hitting his head with my whole body weight and moving through. So it can still, like a lot of the good sections and so on, it can be forgivable to a certain degree from what we can actually see. You've just got to remember that even if you can't grab it there, you might grab it there. Okay? Last bit, the obvious one, which is probably quicker and easier to do, depending on the area of course, is go for the thrust, knock it down, and come straight back up. Do the slows, and we're being very gentle and nice. So that's always an option as well, even if it tries to move in. Simple, and just moving it up. Very easy. Oh yeah, by the way, fans of the health bar will notice it's not really healthy now. Thanks guys.